welcome to Regarding Change. My name is Alison Whiteacre, and each week I have a conversation with an extraordinary everyday person about major changes that they've made in their life. This week's transformer is Dave Friedman. Hi, Dave.
Alison.
How are you today?
I'm doing great. Thanks for asking.
Good. Thanks for coming on Regarding Change.
Thanks for having me.
So I got a little bio here. I should probably use it so that people get to know a little bit about you first. Okay. Dave Friedman was born and raised in Cincinnati, lived in Boston for 25 years, and currently lives on the West Coast. He spent many years touring as a rock and roll musician. Dave took a break to raise a family and work in high tech, and then he joined his wife and her marketing company. Dave is currently expanding his window cleaning business and building his transition coaching practice. So Dave, tell us about some major changes that you've made in your life over the years.
Well, let's start with the latest. Since it was right here, you said that I'm building a transition coaching business.
Yeah, what does that mean?
This is my fifth career, actually, if you look at it like that. I'm very excited. I found it through a speaking career that I had, actually talking to a coach. And through the process of talking to the coach, I found out what I really want to do is help people. And what I really want to do is coach them. It's somebody that I've been my whole life, so it was a perfect fit. And as soon as I came into that realization, boom, the universe said, okay, Dave, you're right. And everything just fell into place like dominoes.
Wow.
A beautiful thing. I'm really excited.
Yeah, when did that happen? What brought that on?
I have been a spiritual counselor of sorts for about 10 years. Mm-hmm. So this is really just expanding on that.
What's a spiritual counselor?
Well, it is a place where you can go and get clear and find some peace in a place where you're finding disruption, where you're unsure of what's going on, where you don't know really who you are. You're kind of lost. I can see through the forest, whereas you're so caught up in the trees. It's a lot like coaching.
Yeah.
More specialized.
Right. Specialized more on spiritual as opposed to
general
career changes or relationship changes.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, what have been some notable transitions that you've made in your life?
Well, obviously coming off the road and being a dad, that was one. Coming off the road and working a corporate job, that was another one. I was an example of what happened in 2008.
Oh.
When the market crashed, when the housing boom exploded. I had a nice house, I had a nice car, I had 2.3 kids, you know, the dog, the whole thing. And the market crashed and we ran out of money. And it's really weird. All the people I owed money to, they said, you know what? If you're not going to pay for your house, you can't live there anymore. I'm going like, what up with that? If you're not going to pay for your car, you can't be driving it anymore. So it was, you know, I make light of it. It's a great way to get through it. But, you know, bare facts, lost the house, lost the car, lost the family, lost everything.
Wow.
And had to kind of rebuild myself from there.
So what happened after you, all of that stuff just sort of fell through?
It was a piece by piece rebuilding.
Mm-hmm.
I was very fortunate. I had given some stuff away. For instance, I found this place to live and they wanted $400 and I only had 50 and I didn't know what to do. And so a buddy calls me up and says, hey, I just sold something of yours that you gave me and it feels to me like you should have half of it. Boom, there's rent. Had a piece of shit car blew up. I played a gig, $150. Boom, there's a $150 car. That kind of stuff, right?
Right.
And clearing up all of the back mess, things like that continued to happen to me.
Curious, how long was the arc of, you know, the market crashing to the point where you were at your lowest point?
Well, I hit bottom pretty quick.
Yeah.
I started trying to do some handyman stuff. I had already lost all my tools, but I bought another screwdriver so I could hang a picture. Then I bought a hammer, you know, so I'm starting to get that crawling under people's toilets. But that's what you do, you know, to get. And a guy I had met knocking on doors said, "Hey, I got this business. Let's go clean windows." Okay. So here's how you water, and here's how you take it off, and here's how you price it. Go. I started knocking on doors. Someone said, "Yes, I clean windows." So I went and knocked on more doors. So I guess I was down for probably almost 3 years before that window business hit me. Mm-hmm. And that started to solidify, and I built something that has kept me going for 11 years now.
So what have been some of the greatest lessons that you've learned having gone through losing, the classic losing everything?
I can count on me.
Okay.
I got this. Uh-huh. Anything else that happens, anything else I may have had or lost, or it's just stuff. I learned that I'm good and I got this. Whatever happens, I can do this. And judging by your wallpaper, we're both musicians too.
That's right. Yeah.
So you played for quite a few years.
Yeah. Yeah, I started in the choir when I was six. And then I got a singing scholarship when I was 10. So I went to a boarding school, choir school in England. It was kind of like Hogwarts, except the only magic that was happening was in the music.
Yes.
And, you know, played cricket, loved cricket. But yeah, what's that?
And music is magic, isn't it?
Music is magic, absolutely. So yes, I had a long, long career in music. Now I just do it for fun. And I basically transitioned into being a life coach around the same time that I transitioned with my gender, you know, transitioned from Billy to Allison. So those worked well together.
That's one of my jokes, as far as, you know, man created linear time so everything doesn't happen all at once. Dismal failure. Right?
Oh, well.
You did all that at the same time. Gender, music, coach, boom, here.
It's a process. I'm just blown away every day by, and this is something I started noticing a long time ago, and it's no big, huge cognition, but just on the grand scheme of things, how many moments of now are there in a lifetime? It's just mind-boggling. There's one, the one that you're in right now, but I just meant on that continuum that you were sort of talking about.
So I expect that your transition from Billy to Allison has a lot to do with your ability to really be a intuitive, compassion, empathetic coach, because you've actually been through something fairly substantial. And you're able, I would expect, and I've talked to you, and you have a real nice way about you. I would expect that you have a real, what would be considered a safe place for someone to feel that they could unpack whatever it is that they're going through, and that you could help them.
I absolutely try to create that. And I've done a lot of work on myself and my inner critic and also my inner judger.
Yes.
To make sure that I really am not, I don't have an agenda when I coach somebody, that I'm there for their agenda. And that's one of the reasons why I love coaching, because actually you get to give up your agenda. I mean, your agenda is to help, but it's one of the great gifts that I've received from coaching, is giving up my ego in any kind of a situation. I shouldn't say in any, just giving up so much of it. I was had so much ego wrapped up in music. And I pretty much had to give it up professionally in order to be able to just let go of relating my significance, my basic goodness to how good I was in music. And, you know, as soon as you start thinking like that in coaching, you let go of any possibility of having that empathy, intuition, to be able to hear the energy behind the story that you're hearing, and be able to have, you know, be able to just pull out of the ether the powerful questions that your client is waiting to be asked. So, yeah, well, thanks.
There's a funny story. I actually got a job cleaning the windows at the house I used to own. That was weird.
Did you get some empowerment out of that?
Well, here's a weird thing. As I got closer to the actual address itself, I started getting that adrenaline thing, right? Mm-hmm. And it was my house. And I went up there and I had no feeling to it. I had no attachment to it, which is a good example. Why worry? You don't know what's going to happen when you get there.
Mm-hmm.
Clean the windows.
Yeah. Well, I admire your ability and willingness to be vulnerable in this discussion.
I'm learning to be open to that. I think that's another thing that I've learned over time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a son of a Depression era parents, you know, and they were like, everything is held inside. That's what I learned.
Mm-hmm.
And it's uncomfortable, actually.
Yeah.
Getting out there and sharing, quite honestly, but it's a little bit freeing. And I learned so much more about me when I do it. And in the process, I can be so much better for the people that I serve.
Absolutely. Yeah, for years I hid behind my guitar and my music. And, you know, being a coach, it's, you can't, you have to be willing to go. Well, you can only take your client as deeply as you've gone yourself. So that's such a big part of it. And that's one of the reasons why I love it so much, is that I am doing what I think I've always wanted to be doing with my life, which is to go deeply, to be intimate, to share, and to be vulnerable.
What a great feeling that is.
Yeah. Well, thanks so much for coming on Regarding Change, Dave.
Thanks for having me. It's great talking to you.
Yeah.
Great visiting with you.
Yes. Yes. We've been having a chat. So how can people find out more about you and connect with you to find out more and possibly get some coaching?
Well, I have a website, coachdaveforyou.com. The letter four. That's actually a number, isn't it?
Number four.
Coachdaveforyou.
I'll put it in the.
Okay. Thank you. You can find me, Coach Dave, on Facebook. My LinkedIn presence isn't ready yet, but it'll probably be something like, I don't know, Coach Dave.
Okay. Great.
But we're out there.
Yeah. Well, thanks again for coming on Regarding Change. And if you haven't, folks, I'm not talking to you, Dave. If you haven't hit that subscribe or rung the bell yet, and you made it this far in the episode, then you might want to do that. So for now, signing off, I'm Alison Whiteacre, and I hope you have an amazing day. Bye, Dave.
Take care.